The acrid smell of child vomit blisters my nostrils, like taking a bite of something you expected to taste sweet but has actually gone rotten. The sick child across the aisle of the bullet train could become an outlet for my frustration. But after spending 3 days in one of the world's most crazy cities, Tokyo, Japan, my senses are actually used to being so highly stimulated right now. Before we get into this, if you're interested in the life of a surfer and filmmaker, make sure you subscribe to the channel because I'm always uploading interesting content. You can also join me on Instagram at Kale's Broccoli. On the train from the airport, the first thing I noticed about Tokyo is how courteous everybody is. Despite being one of the most densely populated cities in the world, it mostly runs like a well-oiled machine, especially if you speak and read Japanese. It's taken us about 2 hours to get to our hotel from the airport. It's chaotic, filled like sardines before in here. And the trouble with transferring to different trains, everything's written in Japanese first, and then there's like these tiny little English words which are very hard to find, so it's a very good introduction to Tokyo. Overall, the train system in Tokyo is incredibly complex and difficult to navigate. This is because different train tracks are leased or operated by different companies, meaning unnecessary transfers take place, even for the simplest of journeys.
That's no good.
A 5 kilometer ride can turn into 3 different transfers due to this reason. However, the local people take it in their stride, marching between trains with a stoic, formal stride and politeness rarely seen in such a populated city. For me, the second biggest stress is the temperature fluctuations doing this. Whilst the fresh spring air sits at around 14 degrees Celsius outside, the trains themselves downstairs can cook at a balmy 27 degrees of stale, sweaty air. My tip, wear easily removable layers. Every time we come in here, we get totally lost.
That says West Bus Station. That might be, oh, that's
exit.
A street.
There's an exit just
that's
here.
A street.
Okay.
Okay, let's go up here.
Let's go up here. After getting frustrated a few times at the constant transfers and the sweaty betties to the cold shivers, I realised that this is just part of the Tokyo experience. And even something as simple as appreciating the low volume of the stations, despite there being sometimes thousands of people present, it made me develop a huge respect for how the Japanese conduct themselves publicly. Riding these trains, you'll also notice hundreds of people who are known as salarymen. 20 to 50 year old, predominantly male but increasingly female Japanese who often nod off as they commute to and from their office jobs. I can't even imagine how so many people are employed, but what I can imagine, just by the looks on their faces, is how stressful life must be working in a dimly lit office all day and having to come home in the late hours in a suit on a steaming hot train. But regardless of all that, the hectic transportation and all the effort to get here, this is what it's all about. For only 1 week out of the year, this stuff happens. It's cherry blossom season. And although we're right at the tail end of it, I think we're going to see some amazing stuff. How cool is that? The blossoms are out in the springtime, but it's a very limited window, sometimes only 7 days. Many people book trips to Japan during this period only to be disappointed by unopened buds or empty trees. This means we were incredibly lucky. We're in the Shinjuku Goyen National Gardens and you can see all the leaves blowing over and you understand why it's such a popular area. I mean, stacks of people are coming down all to get the best shots possible, even though it's not the signature pink cherry blossoms. They are nice and white. It's still pretty magical. It's the perfect place for budding artists and photographers to get some scenic practice in. First thing you notice is that there's a variety of different colors. comes to the cherry blossoms. Not just the pink and not just the white, but everything in between. It's quite fascinating to walk around and just check out. I could stay here for hours. Should we stay here for hours? Alas, though, it's time to go. We're just checking into our hotel. $1,213 comes with a free little Australian girl. Wow, that's a nice little room. Very little. For a specific food store that we knew had really good authentic Japanese food, but it's incredibly difficult to find because there's just so much going on. We're in Shinjuku right now. This isn't even the busiest suburb you can hear, like it's just crazy, but we've just found the place. We're gonna go get some food now. It's looking good.
I think they've got order iPads. You can order.
Origato.
Portugal. Oh my god. Miso soup?
In Japan, you always say itadakimasu. Itadakimasu before you eat, which just translates to something like thank you. And just showing a little bit of gratitude for the meal. And then if it's a miso shiru or miso soup comes with the meal, you have some sips of that first before getting stuck in. How good does this meal look? Seriously. Overall, the food in Japan has been super nice. I started off my trip in Okinawa filming for my next documentary and really got to eat what the locals eat in a traditional sense. Tokyo itself has much more variety and Western influence. However, the authentic, savory, vegetable and seafood rich cuisine still prevails if you really want it to. We finish dinner and head out into the surrounding Shinjuku area to be bedazzled by the shining lights and electric comic energy of the town. In Tokyo nightlife, there really is something for everyone. It's chaotic, but it's surprisingly mesmerizing and beautiful. Look at it, it's just nuts! I'm pretty sure we just ended up in the red light district of Tokyo. There's a whole lot of weird stuff going on. Some of it enjoyable, some not so much. The blossoms were calling us again that evening, so we decided to head to the park after soaking up some nightlife. We were treated to some seriously cool sights. This is what the cherry blossoms look like at night. What a stunning, stunning image these trees present right now. We found a lot. Tokyo's way more, way less conservative than I thought it was. That's it for day one. We're gonna go to bed. If you're interested in the life of a surfer and filmmaker, make sure you subscribe to the channel because I'm always uploading interesting content. You can also join me on Instagram at Kale's Broccoli.